Recorded Books present Here's Hank, How to Hug an Elephant by Henry Winkler and Lynn Oliver, illustrated by Scott Garrett, read by Henry Winkler. Chapter 1. We're off to the zoo, Miss Flower said as the doors of the yellow bus closed. Everyone cheered. Our whole class had been looking forward to this field trip for weeks. My best friend Frankie and Ashley, they were sitting in the seat in front of me. And I had the bad luck to have gotten Nick McKelty as my partner. That meant I had to sit next to him on the bus. And that meant I had very little seat. Nick the Tick's thick body took up most of it. Now, I don't mean to gross you out, but my right butt cheek was riding in the air. What do most of you want to see at the zoo? Miss Flowers asked as she walked up and down the aisle, collecting our lunches. One of the parents, Miss Shimizato, held the big yellow container where our lunches would be kept until it was time to eat.
A giant squid,
Luke Whitman said, handing her his brown paper bag with a salami grease mark covering the bottom.
We're going to the zoo, Luke, not the aquarium, Miss Flowers said.
Her voice sounded like she was holding her nose, even though she wasn't. That happens a lot around Luke. What about you, Hank?
I want to see a giraffe's tongue, I said.
I hear they're purple and covered in hair.
So are you, Zipperfang, Nick said.
He threw his arms up in the air and burst out laughing at his usual not funny joke. Now that one movement put my nose right next to his armpit, which is not a place any nose wants to be. It smelled like rotten eggs on toast.
Giraffe tongues are dark in color to protect them from getting sunburned, Miss Flowers said. And their tongues are out a lot when they're picking leaves off trees.
That set off a whole lot of conversation about weird but true animal facts. It seemed like everyone on the bus knew one. It was a fun way to spend the bus ride.
Spiders have 8 legs and 48 knees, Katie Sperling said.
Kangaroos cannot walk backwards, Frankie chimed in.
Tigers have striped skin, not just striped fur, Ryan Shimizato said.
His mom smiled proudly as if she had just said it herself.
Elephants are the only animals that cannot jump, Ashley said.
That's because they weigh up to 15,000 pounds, hard to get off the ground.
I love them anyway, I said to Ashley. I've watched lots of shows about them on television. I hope we get to see one today.
Well, Hank, I think you're going to get your wish, Miss Flowers said. There is an elephant enclosure at the zoo.
Can we go there first? I begged.
We have a tour guide who has planned the whole morning for us, Miss Flowers said.
It's important that we all stay together. Remember our most important rule, no wandering away.
And that goes especially for you, Hank. She didn't even have to say why. I knew what she meant. I get lost a lot. Maybe it's because I still can't tell my left from my right. Last week, Miss Flowers gave me the attendance sheet to take to the office. She said, walk to the end of the hall and turn right. Then go to the water fountain and turn left. I thought I followed her directions perfectly. That is until I pulled the door open and walked right into the girls' bathroom. Lucky for me, it was empty.
The zoo is very large, Miss Flowers explained, as we pulled into the parking lot. You are each responsible to always know where your partner is. After we entered the zoo, we met our tour guide, Gina, who told us that our first stop was Gorilla World. While she was telling us all about what we were going to see, I noticed Nick wandering away. He was heading for a cart that sold toy zoo animals. And since he was my partner, it was my responsibility to tell him to stay with the group. His back was to me, so I couldn't see what he was doing. I snuck over to him and whispered in his ear, so Miss Flowers couldn't hear.
You're not supposed to be here, I said.
Suddenly, he wheeled around and flashed what looked like a rat in front of my face. Before I could do anything, he dropped it down the front of my shirt. It felt cold and sticky. Yuck! I screamed before I could stop myself. I pulled my shirt out of my pants, and the sticky thing fell out of the bottom of my shirt onto the ground. I looked down and I saw it was just a rubber rat. I turned around to tell McKelty how annoying that was, and he had already snuck back to the group. So I stood there, alone, with everyone in the class laughing at me. Everyone but Miss Flowers. She did not look happy. "Hank," she said, "what was the last thing I said to you on the bus? No wandering away." "But Miss Flowers, I was just trying to be responsible." "Well, you didn't succeed, Hank. Now, please, apologize to Gina for interrupting her introduction to Gorilla World." I apologized, but it wasn't fair. It was McKelty who had wandered away. I had only gone after him to help. We started down the path that led to the gorillas.
"I'm gonna have a fun day with you, Zipper Butt," McKelty said. "You're my favorite kind of partner. You make the animals in this zoo seem smart."
I looked at Frankie and Ashley, who were at the front of the line asking Gina a lot of questions. They seemed very happy. Then I looked at Nick McKelty next to me, who snickered just before he tripped me.
"Watch your step,"
the big creep said. Only one thought was running through my mind. Why did I get stuck with this guy? Chapter 2. Gorilla World was really cool. We walked along the path next to the rainforest that the zoo had built to house about 20 gorillas. And when we stopped, Gina told us all about them. It was hard to listen to what she was saying because I was waiting to see the gorillas swing from tree to tree. But they just sat there on the ground picking bugs.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.